What do you usually think about when you hear the word pollution? Most people associate it with images such as factories, oil extraction facilities, and vehicle exhaust pipes. However, there is a hidden type of pollution that is still not as relevant as it should probably be, one to which we're even more directly exposed to than exhaust gases, and that can be even produced by bikes.
Non-exhaust emissions mainly refer to vehicle brake and tire wear particle emissions. The largest quantities of non-exhaust emissions, in terms of mass, are generated through wear processes. My name is Theo Grigoratos and I work for the European Commission's Joint Research Centre. Our mission at the JRC is to provide independent and evidence-based science with the aim of supporting policy making at the EU level. Among others, I have steered the development of brake emissions and tire abrasion regulations at the UNEC level. I have supported the development of the Euro 7 regulations that includes for the very first time limits on brake and tire emissions. The largest quantities of non-exhaust emissions in terms of mass are created through wear processes within the brake system and tire and road interface when we talk about tire emissions. Brakes are more relevant to ambient air pollution since they are a significant source of particulate matter, the so-called PM10 and PM2.5. On the other hand, tire released material is typically bigger in size and mainly affects water and soil bodies. Non-exhaust emissions have drawn attention over the last 10 years due to the significant reduction of exhaust emissions as a result of the successful implementation of the regulatory framework on exhaust emissions. It was about in 2015 when the newly registered vehicles, at least in Europe, emitted equal or lower exhaust emissions compared to non-exhaust emissions. Although non-exhaust emissions are found in remote areas due to the long-range transport of the particles, they are way more relevant in urban areas where more people live. Regarding brakes, traditional grey cast iron discs coupled with the European tire pads emit the highest amounts of brake emissions. Drum brakes, due to their enclosed nature, emit only a fraction of traditional grey cast iron disc brakes. There are alternative pad formulations, for instance the non-asbestos organic that are being used in the US and Japan, that emit 3 to 5 times lower compared to the European pads. Finally, regenerative braking has the potential to significantly reduce brake emissions due to the very low use of the friction brake.
According to experts, the only way to actually reduce brake emissions is through the electrification of the fleet. The issue with that is that the process of electrification implies a heavier weight for the vehicle. Unfortunately, it's precisely heavier vehicles that produce higher amounts of non-exhaust emissions from tires. Nonetheless, if we consider the complete elimination of exhaust emissions with the adoption of electric vehicles and the fact that non-exhaust emissions are significantly reduced in more recent systems, the increase in tire emissions resulting from electric vehicles is not so important in environmental terms. This is one of the main reasons these types of cars and vehicles are highly promoted through policies in the US and the European Union.
Specifically for bicycles, when one considers the overall environmental benefits along with the impact of a healthier lifestyle, one may conclude that non-exhaust emissions is a negligible problem. Regarding the environmental impact of non-exhaust emissions, approximately 500,000 tons of tire microplastic are released in the environment annually in the EU. This puts tires at the top of the sources of unintentionally released microplastics in the EU. Tire microplastic pollution affects air, soil and water compartments and may cause damage to ecosystems and biodiversity loss. Unlike exhaust studies, there are no epidemiology studies directly linking adverse health effects with non-exhaust emission particles. We have seen that there are many studies in the field which, however, have produced contradictory results. Brake particles are small enough to enter the human respiratory system and go deeper into the lungs. The chemical composition of this particle includes potentially harmful elements like heavy metals. Regarding tire microplastic emissions, we are now in the phase of understanding the implication of their presence in all environmental compartments. For this reason, more dedicated studies are needed to reach a sound conclusion.
It's not all bad news. Though their specific effects on human health might not yet be fully understood, new regulations like Euro 7 will be useful to tackle the challenges posed by non-exhaust emissions. And outside of Europe, it's also not so bad news. Right.
The United Nations GTR number 24 and the United Nations Regulation 117 will be used as basis for regulating both sources in the European context. These two regulations, which by the way are the first ever regulations on non-exhaust emissions, may be used by other regions worldwide to mitigate non-exhaust emissions.
Ah, thanks.
I would like to point out that in order to mitigate the environmental and health risks stemming out of non-exhaust emissions, it is not only important to implement policies that reduce emissions from their sources, but also promote alternative modes of transportation that generate fewer particle emissions in the first place. In other words, preventing is much better than mitigating.